Hello, what's good? What's Gucci? It's your boy Anansi. Welcome to the Kickback, and today we're going to be doing an anime review for Demon Slayer Kimetsu no Yaiba, Episode 6. Let's get straight to it. Alright, so yo, bruh, we got a winner with this one. Back at it again with the heat. My boy Tanjiro starts off the episode looking clean as hell, clad in his Demon Slayer Corps uniform and his Ninjutsu sword on his hip, ready for that action, ready to head off for his first mission. Alright? He says his goodbyes to, you know, Urokodai, and he gets presented with a gift for Nezuko. It's a box. The gift was a box for Nezuko to hide in. But there's no holes though, so like, how is she breathing? Do demons not need air? Anywho, Tanjiro heads to town where young girls have been vanishing night after night. He meets up with his kid, Kazumi, where he tells his story and he takes Tanjiro to the site of his girlfriend's disappearance. Now Tanjiro starts investigating through the power of his nose and he finds his demon target and a girl's hit and a human girl scent, right? Now this is where the episode gets real. Tanjiro tracks down the demon and with his new sword, old boy deals a wound and saves the girl and has Kazumi guard her, right? Then the demon squads up on Tanjiro and my boy pulls out another new technique called water breathing A-form waterfall basin. Whew, that was a mouthful. Almost as bad as Super Saiyan Gen God Super Saiyan. Like, why you just couldn't call that Super Saiyan Blue? Anywho, this episode introduces us to Kibutsuji Muzan, the soul demon responsible for turning humans into a demon. That was my Urokodai impression, if you couldn't tell. But anyway, we got introduced to him like mad early, way earlier than I expected. Because let's be honest here, Tanjiro is stronger now, but you know, it's not like he's powerful to handle a demon of this caliber, right? I guess it just gives him a target to aim his anger at, in addition to his motivation for turning his sister back into a human. But I don't know, I think it's too early. Unless they bring in Kibutsuji early just to have him beat Tanjiro's ass and spare him just to further his character development, then I'm okay with that. Anyway, continuing, Tanjiro was holding his own against the demon. He dealt some damage, but he couldn't get a decisive blow due to Kazumi and the girl being too close to efficiently swing his sword. He almost got caught up at one point until Nezuko hopped out with the Sanji from One Piece kicks. Just straight brought it down on him. What was it called? Diabo Jambo or some shit like that? Oh, I fucked that up. I'm pretty sure I fucked that up. Mad. Oh, man. But like, she just straight gave that demon's neck a 720 spin, bro. Like, she kicked him so crazy and stupid. And then the episode basically ends from here. Bro, this is my show. I kind of want to read the manga, but I don't want to spoil it for myself. I like being surprised, but I might have to make that sacrifice soon if it keeps up. Next week's episode looks fire. I might have to make my decision to read up then. But who knows? But all right, y'all, I'm out. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe if you're new. Look forward to more reviews. Got some drawings coming through. And be sure to hit that bell icon to be notified when I drop something new. All right? Late.